Welcome to a video on the binomial theorem. This video uses combinations to determine the missing factors rather than Pascal's triangle. Let's first take a look at the patterns we can recognize when we expand the binomial x plus y. For example, if we take a look at the quantity x plus y raised to the third, notice the variable part of the first term is x to the third, and the next term has x to the second, so the exponent has decreased by 1, but then we start picking up factors of y. This would be y to the first. Notice the sum of the exponents is still 3. The third term, we have x to the first, so the factors of x has dropped by 1 again, and we've picked up another factor of y, all the way to y to the third. So if we jump down to the quantity x plus y to the fifth, notice we have x to the fifth, then x to the fourth, y to the first, x to the third, y to the second, and so on. So as we go from left to right, we lose factors of x's, and pick up factors of y. Next in red, we have these coefficients that we found last time using Pascal's triangle, but now we'll take a look at how we can find them using combinations. Let's go ahead and take a look at the binomial theorem. So this can look a little intimidating, but again, the idea here is to recognize the pattern. Notice the exponent on x in the first term matches the original exponent, and then we decrease the factors of x by 1, and start picking up factors of y. And then those red coefficients on the previous screen can be found from these combinations, n choose 0, n choose 1, n choose 2, all the way to n choose n. Let's see if we can apply that to expand the quantity x plus 3 to the fourth power. Let's first write out the variable part, and then we'll come back and find the combinations. So the first term would be x to the fourth, and 0 factors of 3, plus then we'd have 3 factors of x, and we'd start picking up factors of 3. Notice that instead of y we have 3, but the process is going to be the same. Plus, then we'll have 2 factors of x and 2 factors of 3, plus 1 factor of x and 3 factors of 3, and lastly we have 0 factors of x and 4 factors of 3. So now to find the missing factors here, we'll start finding combinations. This first one will be n choose 0 or 4 choose 0. The second will be 4 choose 1. We'll continue this all the way out to 4 choose 4. So when we find these products, this will be the expansion of this binomial. Let's go and show a little more work here. 4 choose 0 would be 4 factorial over n minus r factorial. That's 4 factorial and then 0 factorial times x to the fourth plus 4 choose 1 would be 4 factorial, 3 factorial, 1 factorial times x to the third times 3 plus 4 choose 2 would be 4 factorial, 2 factorial, 2 factorial, x to the second, 3 squared, that would be 9, plus 4 choose 3, that's 4 factorial, 1 factorial, 3 factorial. Notice that 4 choose 1 and 4 choose 3 are the same. X and then 3 to the third, that would be 27. And then lastly, 4 choose 4, that's going to be the same as 4 choose 0. 4 factorial, 0 factorial, 4 factorial. Times 3 to the 4th, that's going to be 81. So this would be equal to 1, so we have x to the 4th. 4 factorial over 3 factorial, that's going to be 4, and 1 factorial is 1, so we have 4 times 3, that'd be 12x cubed, plus 4 factorial over 2 factorial, 2 factorial. Well, 2 factorial times 2 factorial would be 4. So this would equal 6 times 9, that's 54x squared, plus this is equal to 4 times x times 27, that's 108x. And then lastly we have this is equal to 1 times 81, so we have 81. Let's go and take a look at another one. Here we have the quantity 2x minus 3 raised to the fifth power. So again, let's first write out the patterns with these two terms, and then we'll write in the combinations to find the missing factors. So for the first term, we'd have 2x to the fifth. plus, and then we'll lose one factor of 2x. So we'll have 2x to the fourth. Now the second factor is going to be negative 3 because we have a minus 3 here. Remember, we could write this as 2x plus negative 3. So we have a negative 3 to the power of 1 plus 2x to the third, negative 3 to the second, plus 2x to the second, negative 3 to the third. We'll have to go down to the next line now. We have plus, this would be 2x to the first, and negative 3 to the fourth. Remember, these are always adding to 5. And we have one more term here. It's going to be 2x to the 0 power, that's 1. Then we have negative 3 to the 5th power. To find the missing factors in front, we'll find combinations. This will be 5 choose 0. This will be 5 choose 1. 5 choose 2. And you see the pattern. Now we just have to find the values of these combinations and then find the products. 5 choose 0 is 1. So 1 times 2 to the 5th, that would be 32x to the 5th, plus, let's go ahead and use our calculator now. 5 choose 1 is equal to 5, so we have 5 times, we have a factor of negative 3, and we also have 4 factors of 2, 2 to the 4th. So it's negative 240, so this will be negative 240x to the 4th. So we'll write this as minus 240x to the 4th. Next, we're going to have 5 choose 2 times, this would be 2 to the 3rd times negative 3 squared. So 5, option 3, so 5 choose 2 times 2 to the 3rd times negative 3 squared, which would be 9. So we have 720, and this would be x to the 3rd. So for the next term, we're going to have 5 choose 3 times 2 squared times negative 3 to the 3rd. We said times 2 squared, which is 4. And then negative 3 to the 3rd would be negative 27. So we have negative 1,080, so I'll write down minus 1,080. It would be x squared. We've got two more terms here. So 5 choose 4 times 2 times negative 3 to the 4th. Well, 5 choose 4 would be 5 times 2 times negative 3 to the 4th is going to be positive 81. So we have 810. This would be x to the 1st. And normally we would not put this exponent on there, so I'll go ahead and take it off. And then for the last term, we have 5 choose 5, that's equal to 1. And we have negative 3 to the 5th, that's going to be negative 243, so we write down minus 243. So now that we've learned about combinations, we can find these missing factors by using combinations or by using Pascal's triangle. I hope you found this video helpful.